A very warm welcome to Economicspedia. So, in our course of study during economics for various purposes, whether we are in college or we are in university pursuing our master's, MPhil, and or even if we are preparing for the competitives, there are always something that we miss out, isn't it? And there are always something that that you need to brush up once in a while, because the concepts are very much near to each other, very much close to each other, and that makes it very difficult to remember and to portray in your exams. So that is why today in this session we are going to discuss one of those topics, a very important, a very confusing, yet a very interesting topic from econometrics. The basic difference between R square and R bar square, or which is also known as the adjusted R square. So here we are providing the difference between the R square and adjusted R square. So let's get started without any further delay. Now, as I've mentioned, that these are the topics from the econometrics. So more important to that is that we need to focus on the time series portion in order to understand this area. So I'm taking a simple two variable model. Okay, let's say yi is equal to beta 1 beta 2 xi plus of the error term. Let this be equation number 1, and our error term, that is ui, all the classical linear regression assumptions hold. If any one of you want me to teach and go through the important concepts of classical linear regression model, CLRN, please let us know by writing your views below in the comment section. We'll be waiting for that. Okay, so this is the time series model, two variable time series model. What is R square? R square is nothing but goodness of fit. Goodness of fit. This means what? This whole phrase means what? It means that this is the dependent variable, right? And this is the independent portion. So, this goodness of fit tells us how well the SRF, that is the sample regression function, fits the model. That means how well the explanatory independent variable can explain the dependent y variable, that gives us, that is given us by the goodness of fit. Okay, so this is a very important definition of the goodness of fit, that is how much the SRF is describing or fitting is the word. So how well the SRF is explaining the model, that is being captured by the goodness of fit. Okay, so this is the basic definition of it. Now, whenever we are discussing with the two variable model, we represent the coefficient of determination as small r square. This is for two variable model, and for capital R square, whenever we have multiple linear regression model, then we use the capital R square. Okay, so these are nothing but the coefficient of determination. Coefficient of determination. Now, to understand this coefficient of determination, you always need to understand the goodness of fit. What does this mean? And how this is actually applicable into our model. Okay? So, this is about the coefficient of variation. Coefficient of determination. Now, moving on towards an identity that we all know, and with the help of that, I'm going to explain this R square and adjusted R square accordingly. So TSS equal to ESS plus of RSS. So what is TSS? TSS is the total variation in Y about its mean value. Okay, so total variation in yi, small yi, about the mean value. So the total variation is represented as TSS. What is ESS? Variation of the estimated value of y about its mean value. So it is the variation in yi or yi hat. So this is the estimated yi about its mean value. Okay, and finally we have RSS. What is this? It is the residual or unexplained sum of variation in y about the regression line. Okay, so this is the residual variation in yi about the regression line. Alright, so this is the famous identity, and I hope that all of you are aware of it. If not, let us know that you need an explanation on the derivation of this identity. I'll definitely do it. Okay, so this is the identity we need to be focused on right now, because from this I am going to explain the coefficient of determination. Now, let this be equation number 2. And let's divide equation number 2 on both the sides by TSS. So we have 1 over here and ESS by TSS, and here we have RSS by TSS. Okay. Now, what does R square implies, or the coefficient of determination implies? That is how well the SRF, the sample regression function, fits the data or explains the model. Sample regression function. Now, in a sample regression function, we don't have an error term, right? So a sample regression function over here, this portion captures the estimated value of yi. That is the sample regression function has been given by ESS. And what is RSS? This is the residual. Residual sum of squares. So that is why the RSS part does not play any role while explaining the concept of coefficient of determination or R square. So what do we have? The value of R square, you can write it as capital R square or small r square, the value remains the same. It is that ESS divided by TSS. This is the expression of coefficient of determination. Alright, that is the explained sum of squares, or the estimated value of yi about mean divided by the total variation of y about its mean. Alright, now there are some of the properties that you need to know. That this R square, they are non-negative, and the value of this R square lies between 0 to 1. Now, why the value of R square is non-negative? You must be thinking. Coming to that part in a while. In between, let me also highlight, as I've said, that the value of R square lies between 0 to 1. So when it is equal to 1, it means perfect relation. And when it is equal to 0, it implies no relation between the SRF and the PRF or the model. Alright? So this is the basic idea about the coefficient of determination or the R square. Now, from here, I am going to explain that why this R square is non-negative. For that, we will be needing this expression. Let me rewrite it again. So, R square, I am writing capital R square only. ESS, YTSS, we know this. And what is ESS? It is TSS minus RSS by TSS. From where I can write it? Since I have told you that ESS plus RSS is equal to TSS. So because of that, this ESS I have written it in this fashion. And finally, what do we have? We have capital R square. The value of capital R square is 1 minus of RSS by TSS. Now what is R square? Summation UI hat square. And what is TSS? That is summation of YI hat square. This Y is small y, okay? So this is R square, the another form of R square. Now carefully look into this expression. Let me mark it as equation number 3. Now in equation number 3, this small yi square, we know that the dependent term is completely independent of the number of independent terms or explanatory variables, right? It doesn't affect, because if the number of explanatory variable increases, it does not change the value of the dependent variable and so on. So this yi hat square is independent of the explanatory term. It doesn't change, that is increase or decrease. It does not do that. But on the other hand, this summation of ui hat square, that is the RSS, this reduces with the increase in the number of explanatory variable. So there is a negative relation between the number of explanatory variable and RSS. So that is why I have said that R square is non-negative. In a way, it is always positive. Now, if the number of explanatory variable increases, so this implies what? The numerator reduces. Look at it in this way. As number of explanatory variable increases, this implies that ui hat will decrease. And if ui hat will decrease, then summation of ui hat square divided by summation of yi hat square, this reduces. So ultimately what happens? This implies what? The summation of ui hat square and summation of yi hat square, which is nothing but capital R square, this what? This increases. Okay? So that is why R square is non-negative. So if a model, suppose there are two models, then in the both the models the dependent variable is the same. But if the explanatory variable, the number of explanatory variable is different, then how to decide which model to choose? It will depend upon the value of this R square, capital R square. So the higher the value of this R square is, the better the model is. That is, the better the SRF can explain or can better fit the model. Okay, so the higher the value of this R square, the model, that model will always be get selected. Now here comes the adjusted R square, that is R bar square. So here we need to, in case of the two models that I've taken for in order to explain this, so in that two model we need to compare the two R squares. Now since we have to compare the two R squares, we need to take an alternative statistic or measure while doing that. That measure is known as the adjusted R square or R bar square. Let me give you an expression for that. So the adjusted R square or capital R bar square is equal to nothing but summation ui hat square divided by n minus k whole divided by summation yi hat square divided by of n minus 1. Okay, and if you can recall what was R square, it was 1 minus summation ui hat square and summation yi hat square, isn't it? So you can see the difference between this r square and adjusted r square, that these two terms, that is n minus k and n minus 1, because of these two terms, the whole meaning or the measure of statistic got different. So this adjusted r square is nothing, but it is the same r square, that is the coefficient of determination that we know. But here, that coefficient of determination has been adjusted for the degrees of freedom. So this n minus k and n minus 1 in this expression, you can see, let me mark it as equation number 4. So in expression number 4, you can see the n minus k and n minus 1 is nothing but the degrees of freedom. So here k is the number of parameters including the intercept, and n is the total number of sample or the sample size. Okay, so this error term, that is ui hat square, has a degree of freedom of n minus k, and the dependent variable has an degree of freedom of n minus 1. So due to this expression, the two are different. Okay, although they are not very much different from each other, but this adjustment with the degrees of freedom ultimately make them to differ. So an important relation between this adjusted r square and the normal r square plays a very important role while inferring a particular model. Let me discuss that expression for you. The expression is adjusted r square 1 minus of 1 minus r square into n minus 1 divided by n minus of k. This is the relation between the adjusted r square and the normal r square. Now an interesting fact you can note, that as k increases, what is k? K is the number of explanatory variable or parameters. As the number of parameters increases, you can find that r bar square is lesser than r square. This is an important relation. As the number of explanatory variable or the parameters increases, the increase in the adjusted r square will be less than the normal r square. This is one of the properties. Another property, we can say that adjusted r bar square can be negative, but we know that r square, the normal r square, cannot be negative. R square can't be negative. Okay, so these are the two very important properties of this r square and adjusted r square. So in a nutshell, or in a very compact form, in a summary way, we can say that this r square and the adjusted r square, these are nothing, these are the same thing, but they are two different statistic or measure which gives us and help us in order to predict and infer our models. Okay, so this is the basic difference and relation between the coefficient of determination and the, that is r square and the adjusted r square. I hope this video was helpful to you, and if it was, don't forget to hit the like button, and if you are new to our channel, please subscribe to our channel, because we update and give you the important concepts of economics in a very crisp and in a crux manner. And if you have any kind of further queries related to economicspedia, you can contact us through our official mail ID, that is ecopedia02@gmail.com. Thank you for watching this.